Hello everyone, welcome to Web Dev Mentors YouTube channel and we are watching Learning Bootstrap series. In this video, we're going to see about how to add a contact form or creating a contact form, or you can say it as a designing a contact form in your contact page. So if you have seen the last video, we have already added an example form in our contact form section. So this form has been taken from the example that has been given in the Bootstrap documentation section, and you can get the code from here, and in order to copy it very fast, you can use this copy button. And right now I'm going to alter this contact form into such a way that it looks like a contact form. So the basic steps that people used to get from the contact form is the name of the person who would like to contact you, the email address of the person who would like to contact you, the subject in which he wants to contact you, and also the message he wants to contact you. So at this contact form, we are not using any kind of file inputs. We don't want anyone to actually upload a file or attach a file to my email. So I'm going to remove this, and I'm going to add two more fields. One is going to be a normal text field, and another is going to be a text area, and I'm going to convert this into a name field, and this is going to be the email address field. And if you remember, in the last video we have seen why this field has been called as email field, because if you type anything other than an email without an at sign in your text, it will be giving you a warning message saying that it's not looking like an email address. So try to finish it off with an email address. And now I'm using the at, and you can see that it's still saying that after the at, it has not been filled yet. So you finish this and you can enter that. So it's going to work. Right now my contact form is not submitting anything. I just made it to submit for the same page without any kind of process to be done for the contact form. So let's see how to design this contact form in such a way that it looks like a contact form. The first is going to be a normal name. So I'm going to change it to contact name. And I'm going to copy it, paste it in ID, and I'm going to change it to normal text. So here I'm going to put it as name. And we have also used placeholder, so I'm going to change it to enter name. So this is going to hint my users to write the exact same thing that I want to write in that particular field. So in case they are not seeing the label, they can see this hint from the text field and write down what has to be written there. And the next field is going to be the email field, so I'm going to write contact email. Sorry about that. And here, email address. And in here, for the type, I'm going to change it to email. And in here, I'm going to enter the same thing as contact email. And for here, enter email. The next thing I'm going to, I have to add another input field, which is the text field, which is going to be my subject, actually, contact subject. Enter subject, contact subject, copying it and pasting it here. So this actually finished off the first three parts. I'm going to remove this file input part. I don't need it for my contact form, and I'm going to add a simple text area within this division classes. So I'm going to first copy it, paste it in here, put it up again, close it, just going to align it, and I have to create a label for my text area. So I'm going to change the label as message, contact message, and convert it to message. So I'm going to create a text area in here. Sorry about that, text area. And I have to give a couple of things. This is class as form control. So form control class is the one that is going to give you the actual styling for each and every input element from Bootstrap. So don't forget to include this form element, and I'm going to give an ID so that I can actually find out it is there. So I'm going to use contact message. I'm going to save it, and you don't have to give the placeholder text because it's not going to work out in the text area, so don't give it. And I think this is good enough. When we refresh it, sorry about that, just going to press enter, and you can see that. So It is very small for a message to be, so I want to increase the size of it. So I'm going to give a parameter called as rows, so that, and I'm going to give 6 as the value, so that to increase the size of my text area. So now I think this is enough. So check me out. I don't think it's necessary, but if you want to add something like accept the terms and conditions, you can actually add there. But I don't think it's necessary for a contact form. So I'm removing it and I'm having a submit button. So when I refresh it, you can see that a nice contact form is in here. And this is the topic I want to cover today. We have changed the normal contact form or the example contact form that we have copied from the Bootstrap and converted into a contact form. So we have copied a normal example form from the Bootstrap documentation section and pasted it in my website, and we have seen how it looks, but now we have changed it to look as a contact form. We have changed it to have extra elements, extra components, and extra input fields that we want to use in order to get information from our users. So this contact form actually uses 4 input fields. One is the internet, that is the name of the contact person, and then the email address of the contact person, and the subject in which he wants to contact me, and then the message. So this message is going to be conveyed to me, and you can actually submit this, and you can process this form using some of the scripting languages like PHP, ASP, JSP, and Perl, Python, whatever it is, if you're always with it. But if you're looking forward to actually learn some of these technologies, we're good to announce that we are actually creating a PHP learning series. So learning PHP series is going to be uploaded sooner or later in the YouTube channel of Web Dev Mentor. So if you are looking forward to learn PHP, and if you have not subscribed to the channel, this is the right time. Please subscribe to the channel and know when the PHP learning series is uploaded right away. And if you find this video useful, please like this video, share this video, and please subscribe to the channel. And also, if you have any kind of comments, issues, problems, and if you're facing any kind of trouble in doing this, please try to contact us. You can use the comment section of this video in order to contact us, or our Facebook page or our Twitter feed. And if you're also having any kind of feedbacks or suggestions that you want to tell us, please use the comment section again in order to tell us. And also, you can use the Facebook pages and also the Twitter links in order to contact us and let us know what we have to do in order to make it good for you. Thank you for watching this video, and have a great day.